LG has launched the world's first dual-core smartphone, the world's first quad-core smartphone, the world's first quad-HD flagship, and the world's first modular flagship smartphone. Yet, despite all these achievements, and despite sharing the same country of origin as Samsung, it does not enjoy the same level of success as Samsung does in the smartphone world. But to change all that, LG has now come up with LG G6. And it's a different phone from what we've been seeing from LG in the last couple of years. My name is Sid, and in this video, I tell you all about the LG G6. I first talk about its specifications, and then I give you my take and my opinions on the same phone. But just to give you a spoiler, it's another great smartphone from LG that you and I won't be buying. Now, I've been quite vocal about my preference for a compact phone that fits in my palm. Yet, I do understand why some people like larger screen phones. And LG has done something to accommodate everyone here. Last year, LG G5 had a 5.3-inch screen. This year, the LG G6 has a 5.7-inch screen, but LG claims that they have fitted it in a 5.2-inch form factor. Now, that may be true because the phone's design is virtually bezel-free. And in terms of looks, the phone does look quite gorgeous. It's got brushed aluminum back along with strengthening glass on top of it too. Now, LG took a lot of time to tell us about its display, but I'll take a few moments to tell you all about it. The phone packs in a 5.7-inch display that covers most of the front of the smartphone. It is of Quad HD Plus resolution and the aspect ratio is 18:9. This aspect ratio is called Full Vision Display by LG and it makes the phone bigger by making it taller, not wider. So it's easier to use than most other phablets out there in the town. This new aspect ratio is commendable because new age cinematic content and multimedia content would be developed in its accordance. To simplify stuff, you see those black bands when you watch a movie? They would soon be gone. Also, it is the first display to have Dolby Vision display on board and HDR10 technology as well. Moreover, this new aspect ratio allows users to use two apps simultaneously in forms of square. So in terms of display and designing, LG G6 does indeed look very premium and an awesome device, if I may say so. Moreover, the phone is now water and dust proof as well. Next up are the cameras, and that's a section where LG smartphones never disappoint. And this year, it might not be any different. The LG G6 packs in dual 13 megapixels camera at the rear, which should be great because all the inclusions pointed to be so. You get a 125-degree wide-angle lens at the back, you get 4K video recording, and you get seamless optical zoom feature as well. Moreover, selfies have not been ignored. You get a 5-megapixel camera to shoot yourself and a 100-degree wide-angle lens to shoot more people than just yourself. And now let's talk about the internals. The reason why many spec seekers might not go for LG G6. The phone packs in 4GB of RAM on board, but it features last year's Snapdragon 821 CPU, the same one you would find on a OnePlus 3T or a Google Pixel. The reason it does not use the latest Snapdragon 835 CPU is because Samsung is manufacturing those chips for Qualcomm and it wants to be the first one to use it. And it would use it in Samsung Galaxy S8, which comes out in March. And before that, no other company can use it. But with Android Nougat on board and LG's now redesigned Grace UX 6.0, which is faster, smoother and better, speed should not be an issue in my opinion. Moreover, you must consider that LG G6 would be the first non-Pixel smartphone to feature Google's capable voice assistant as well. Lastly, let's talk about battery and other things. You get a 3300mAh cell, which for the first time on an LG G series smartphone would be non-removable. You also get USB Type-C port on the bottom and you get quad DAC audio chip, the same one that was used in LG V20. It allows a sound distortion rate of 0.0002. Basically, it sounds pretty good. And that takes care of the specification part. Now let me tell you my opinions on the phone and why I think you won't be buying it. First, let me say that LG G6 looks like a great smartphone on paper and LG has impressed me yet again with their smartphone. Yet, I cannot be blinded by potential and be oblivious to what is practical. Samsung Galaxy S8 would have a much better CPU and would be a more powerful smartphone. Now, you may call it vindictive from Samsung, but truth is what it is. Also, Samsung is no sissy when it comes to putting features on their smartphones either. So, in retrospect, Samsung Galaxy S8 might be a more powerful and a more feature-packed phone than the LG G6. And many people who want those things would flock to it. And that is fine. When you spend that much money on a smartphone, you should get the best one available in the market. And that's fine. As a consumer, when you spend that much money, you have the right to pick the best phone you can. Moreover, LG has now dropped support for removable batteries and modularity, so it's not a niche anymore. You know, if I were LG, I would have waited for Samsung Galaxy S8 to get launched and then introduce my device. Or I would have announced the LG G6 in MWC, but start shipping it only after March, after in April, where an S8 is launched with my Snapdragon A35 CPU on board. Yet, LG is the best judge to know what's good for LG, and the second best judge is you, the audience. So do let me know in the comment box below, what you think of LG G6, would you be buying it over the Samsung Galaxy S8 or not? And do not forget to hit that subscribe button so that I can tell you more about LG G6 when it comes to India. Moreover, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, sharing it with your friends, and coming back for more. My name is Sid. Ciao.